What is good, everybody? I thought we'd continue with the Serum sound design tutorials, and this one is all about lead sound design slash synthesis. We're going to be looking into all the components inside a Serum that make up an epic lead sound, covering oscillators, randomization, effects, and to help put everything into context, I'll also reference it with some other shit like Sandstorm and Feed Me. So beforehand, I came up with a lead, a bass line, and a chord progression to help make everything gel nicely together. If we're just doing lead design by itself, it might sound a little bit weird when you haven't got it inside of a mix, so to say. And this is what I whipped up before. But for now, let's get into the sound design. Time to make this an initial preset. Oh, it sounds so good already. First things first, when making a lead, you do not need to overcomplicate it. I've jammed my Moog or Moog Sub Fatty throughout tons of videos, and recently I've asked myself, why do the leads always sound so good? They're just basic wavetables with a few modulations and shit. And that's when it clicked. I was like, I'm overcomplicating my leads way too much. So with that being said, basic shapes do sound really good. We can start this off with a saw, pretty basic at the moment. Let's light up Os B and also select the wavetable of basic shapes. That sounds pretty cool already. I'm just picturing it with heaps of distortion and reverb in the background. And I think that's a good fundamental to start. And having an oscillator with no semitones adjusted and one at -7 is the classic Darude Sandstorm effect. As you can see with this patch, no semitones adjusted, it's just one octave up, and if we hear Os B, -7 semitones down. And that's a pretty healthy blend of both oscillator A and B. But then again, that only works with some notes, so if we had our original kind of some notes will work, some notes just won't. It's really dictated on how your song will sound. So if we hear that with, some notes just aren't gelling, but if we go, that sounds great. But for now, we'll just have it set at octaves. This is normal, and this will be an octave down. Another great thing that works really well with lead sound design is setting your voicing to monophonic. If we just play F and, if we overlap the notes, the two notes are going to play together. But if we select monophonic, only one note at a time will play. And we can set the glide between the two notes with this, portamento. Of course, you wouldn't want this with chords because you want to play multiple notes at the same time, but for leads, if you're just jamming single notes at a time, it works beautifully. Personally, I think randomization is a key thing when it comes to lead sound design. By default, Serum just has randomization already at max, which is great. If you think of like a real instrument like a guitar or a piano, if you're doing the same note, you're not going to get exactly the same sound every single time, which is great since it adds a little bit of variation. And in Serum, you can mimic that as well. Pressing the same note sounds the same every single time. Randomization on max for both. Sounds slightly different every single time. So if you see this yellow line here, if I have randomization set to off, guaranteed every single time the oscillator will start at that point. But if I turn it up, the oscillator is gonna start at some random points along here, here, in the middle. And this leads to super subtle phase with the other oscillator, and they both start at random points along here. It's not always gonna gel, but I mean, that's a cool thing. And to add a little bit more variation, we'll use an LFO on some modulation. Then plus one of the modulators, and we'll click and drag the LFO onto that. And we might go bend plus minus for this one, drag the LFO onto that. Set this to off, so if we click notes at random times, it won't necessarily start here. It might start somewhere along here, depending where we are along the grid. Each note being played is sounding slightly different, and you can see the oscillators dancing around. Into the effects section, hyperdimension expander just makes it a little bit wide. Actually, in saying that, I'm gonna make oscillator B wide as well with unison. Back into effects, break this down. make that a bit wider as well. Distortion, depends how much grit you want with your lead. I personally like it somewhere within this region, and if you can hear some like gritty artifacts in the background when the note stops playing, this is because of the dream team of hyperdimension and distortion. If I just had distortion. But if I had hyperdimension, since it's spreading out some of the notes, some of them are coming in slightly delayed. I really like that effect. It kind of mimics like an amplifier with a gate. And if we listen to Feed Me's Lonely Island, it has a similar effect right before the drop. But his one sounds really over the top, and how we can also get that is going to envelope one and make sure the release is set to zero. So whenever we like lift off the note, the sound will just stop. It won't just kind of gradually. I really like that old school distorted amp simulator effect, but let's hear the drop so you don't be like, why didn't he play the drop? Here's the fucking drop. Alright, that's enough of that before I get copyright claimed. Back into effects. Flanger, phaser, chorus, you can add them if you want. It'll add like subtleties and shit. Actually, I might add a little bit of chorus. Turn the mix down. Compressor, OTT with the multiband. Let's hear how that unison's sounding. That's a bit spicy, I'm digging that. Unison is basically adding more of what's already playing here by six. So instead of just one oscillator playing, there's six. Now, if in doubt, if it needs to be blended into the mix, chances are it needs a little bit of reverb. Leads often need to be blended into the mix, so add the decay up and give it a bit more mix. And a bit of low cut as well, we don't need reverb on our bass. We could chuck it before the compressor, so the compressor is... You can hear it already. The compressor is compressing the reverb. But we don't need as much mix if that's happening. We could also add delay as well. I personally like eighths. Maybe we want the delay to play around the mid-range. Maybe around there. That could be a problem if we stop playing and the reverb just kind of spreads everywhere because of the multiband. Lastly, a little bit of EQ. We don't need the bass in our lead since the bass is going to be played by the bass. So we can strip that right out with the high pass or low cut. Hearing it in the mix would help, actually. No, not with Sandstorm. Without OTT. Oh god, I'm advocating putting OTT on absolutely everything. Just... This is an intervention. Sometimes your sounds just don't need OTT. But then when you hear them with OTT, they sound good. And then when you hear them without OTT, they sound empty. So use OTT if you want. If your song starts sounding jacked phase-wise, then maybe ease up on OTT. I think that's it for effects. Let's go back into the os. What if we want even more movement? Envelope 2, filter, 24, cut off there, and then add some attack. And os B as well, we don't want it just doing os A. Give it a subtle wub, release up, no, sustain down. Now, why do we do that with an envelope instead of an LFO? It's because the envelope has attack, decay, and release, so we can play a long note, or we can play a short note. The kind of modulation from the envelope is still messing with this low pass. If we have it on the LFO, it's going to do that set path no matter what note we play. But if we have this, sometimes it could be short notes, sometimes it could be long notes. But for now, we don't need that. I've got one more trick up my sleeve. Back to our original sound. And this one we will use an LFO on, so shift. Gonna create a shape like this. Ramp up, ramp down, ramp up, ramp down. Going for the classic 8-bit slash pendulum style. I'm gonna drop these octaves. Actually, no, I'm not gonna drop this octave. click drag up and set this to a really fast pace, like 30 seconds. And we'll also set this. Maybe OTT without and reverb or... Bit classic. That is a personal favorite, especially chucked in the background. So if we duplicate this and we have these notes playing a higher octave, but we will take off ODT and reverb, compressor, reverb, delay, back into our original. And right click, remove all modulators from the octaves of OS A and OS B. Pair them together. The unison. Filter back on for my last idea. I'm going crazy like a reverb filter. This just wouldn't be an Antidote tutorial without making some crazy shit at the end, so...
A few moments later...
Yeah, reverb was a bit extreme. Let's change the high notch. And add some randomization for this and this. There we go, that's a little bit more tame. And that is that. Start with basic oscillators, work up some modulation, create some randomization, effects, distortion works great, and maybe some monophonic voicing as well with this little button to help change the glide notes. And some crazy ass filtering if you're feeling crazy. So yeah, hopefully you learned a bit from this tutorial. It was a bunch of fun. Subscribe if you're new around here. Have a great day and see ya.